Today we are talking about what your squat should look like. Should your knees be close? Should they be out? How low should you go? All that good stuff. For years, I squatted like this here. Feet straight ahead, straight back and down. Like, honestly, like a lot of textbooks said. Nowadays, I squat with my hips open. And let me tell you the difference. My back pain has gone away. I'm stronger in my hips. My glutes are stronger. Back squat's gone up. All positive things. And here's the difference, and here's what I've learned over the years. If you're not being intentional with your feet from the floor, I've talked about this in several videos, but if you take your foot and you screw your foot into the floor, it's actually locking your hip into place, and that is what's gonna allow you to drive the knee out. So from the floor is what you're doing there. If you have a hard time getting down to that position, so maybe you say, all right, let me have my toes slightly turned out. Let me screw my feet into the floor. And then you're only getting about here. You may have an ankle limitation of range of motion, or it could, most likely it's gonna be that. But I want you to try this. Add a kettlebell, and this is actually gonna help put you into a better position. So same thing, turn your toes slightly out, screw your feet into the floor, hold this kettlebell down, and then let me see if you push this bell out, are you able to get into a good now where your hips are below your knees in that type of squat position? The rule of thumb is whenever you're squatting, if you're way out here and the knee is coming in, that is what is at risk of injury, never here. Just a slight turnout is what we prefer. Wider if you need to, if you have good hips, but the knee's gotta be tracking out. Couple of last minute things here. If you're getting into position and you're trying to squat, and you're hunching over, try pushing out your knees harder. That'll keep you more upright, or perhaps you need more ankle range of motion. I've got Olympic lifting shoes that give me elevated, or even if you just stand on some plates, it's kind of a way to also add some more ankle range of motion. And now I'm able to get really, really upright. If you say, hey Kev, I can't get that low, hurts my knees, or whatever the case may be, here's a couple of stretches for you that I want you to try. Get down on your floor, put this hand out to the side, and work on pressing this knee out. And here's how you do it. I want you to actually, while I'm pressing, I'm gonna push against my hand for 5 seconds and then relax for 10 seconds. So here we go. Push really hard against it. So I'm pushing my knee this way. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then relax, bring your hand down in front. Push, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax, bring it down in front. That's gonna help open up your hips so that you can get into a deeper squat position, just like this here. That's the difference in having your knees close and your hips being open wide. It'll get rid of your back pain so your hip flexors aren't getting jammed up all the time and you're opening up your hips, you'll feel a lot better. Try it the next time when you squat, but most likely use a kettlebell to help sink you down. Keep training hard, guys.